shooting a lot better from the three-point line. But also, you know, we were 30th in the league in defense, and so that's something that we're going to really stress throughout this upcoming season. And, you know, we fouled too much. You know, first game, I think we gave up 43 free throws to the Clippers. So just being able to play defense, have one another's back, and defend without fouling.
You know, one thing with all the guys out injured is that you get a chance to give minutes to the players that I know you've seen work hard and have a chance to show what they can do. So you probably enjoy seeing that, right?
We do. I mean, you know, to their credit, our young guys have been in since May 15th. They've been in just about every day, working on their game, working on their conditioning and their strength. And I think that it's going to pay dividends. It's going to show when the season comes along.
Hey, Coach, what sense have you gotten from the way the teammates are responding to Lonzo and the style and the passing? It seems like it's infectious, but you probably have a better idea.
It is. I mean, you know, just, I mean, obviously anybody who's here can feel the buzz in the building. He's out there on the floor. And a couple of our veteran guys, Jordan Clarkson and Julius Randle, who's sitting next to me tonight, you know, they're saying they're going to have to do some extra conditioning because they love the fact that if they get up the lane, he's going to get off the ball. He's been doing that, getting off the ball early. So it's just been infectious. Our guys, the ball movement's been great. You know, we've run out of gas in the first two games. Haven't been able to finish. But, you know, just guys are just really looking forward to being able to play with somebody that's so selfish.
And, Coach, final thing I'll get your sense. Just as a coaching staff, how much do you can you actually put in here versus what we're going to see in October? And, when you bring Brook Lopez in, you mentioned Clarkson, Randall, Larry, et cetera.
Not very much. I mean, you know, we practiced for 3 days, you know, prior to summer league starting. So just put in some basic things, some things that are real simple, but just stress the fact that we want good ball movement and player movement. And to their credit, they've tried to do that.
Coach, appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right, guys, Brian Shaw for now. Let's go back to you.
Bishaw and Trudell, thank you, guys. We've had 9 lead changes in the game. Lakers have hit 7 threes. Zoom down the middle. Brian's looking to throw it up and down after the give from Caruso.
This Caruso kid is pretty good. He's got court vision. And he makes timely passes, nice shots. So, you know, he can play somewhere in this league for somebody if it's not for the Lakers.
Well, Caruso from Texas A&M, you know, he was born an Aggie, basically. Yeah. Grew up working as the team's ball boy. His two sisters were grads there. Now his dad is the associate AD.
Well, not that. It's pretty cool. I like this game. It's very smooth. So somebody I hope is going to take a serious look at him. Maybe the Lakers will. Got, I don't know how many spots they have open, but you know, all the veterans show up. But it looks like he knows how to play the game. I mean, he is 23 years of age, so he comes in even more mature. A lot of these kids out there. There's a great Zach Randolph. You think he's a Hall of Famer, Zach Randolph?
Probably not.
Probably on the bubble.
Well, because of longevity, he's going to put up some numbers. And
yeah, our producer Bettina says, Bettina Shore says, nah. Bettina's the final word. There's a great
one. Hill gets caught by who else but David Nwaba. The Lakers have it into the front court. Caruso again. Caruso looks to penetrate. Kick it out. Vander Bloom. He's going to shoot 3 free throws.
Somebody fouled by De'Aaron Fox, trying to get over to block that shot.
Mike, when do you think the Lakers will make a decision? Let's wait on that thought, because I know you want to expand on
Lonnie's
pages there also.
He's done a good job in Sacramento, putting together a nice
job.
He got a
lot of heat, but things are turning around for him.
Yeah, I like the challenge they have up there.
Oh, you're going to ask me? I'm going to ask you about when are the Lakers going to spend that $17 million that they have available?
Well, you don't have to spend it. I know you have a certain spend, but you don't just give it away just to give it away.
Do you think they will, though?
Well, there's a couple of good, there's a good range on there, Contavious Caldwell-Pope. He turned down $580 million for 5 years, so he's looking for a long-term deal. So I'd be surprised if he takes the Lakers money for 1 year.